Alléluia, 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 Alléluia.
What should be done when a couple or the husband uses weapon when they fight?
All married couples must establish their own private home. Rise to our feet, please.
Hey, Joe, I just can't do it.
as we sing this song loud and clear.
Me out to call you long to Dagara.
Jehovah is your Jehovah is your name. It's mighty warrior, great in battle. Jehovah is your name. Jehovah is your name.
Jehovah is your name.
Jehovah is your name.
Jehovah is your name.
Of man, you are the only God. There is none like you.
All other gods,
all other gods,
other gods,
they are the works of man. You are the only God.
Hallelujah.
There is none like you.
All other gods.
You are the only God. There is none like you.
From east to west, there is no other God. From north to south, I say there is no other God. There is no other God.
From east to west.
Exalt the name of Jesus. Magnify the Lord with me. Exalt the name of Hallelujah.
Magnify the Lord with me.
Hallelujah.
Exalt the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Magnify the Lord with me. Exalt the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah. Unchangeable,
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 unchangeable, unchangeable,
unchangeable,
unchangeable, unchangeable,
unchangeable,
unchangeable, unchangeable, unchangeable,
Oh, Jesus, 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 o
Without any pity for any enemy. Every plan against my glory. Scatter in the name of Jesus. Scatter the plan against your glory. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Some powers opposing my next level. This is a prayer for those who are going to the next level.
Hey,
opposing my next level. You are a liar. In the name of
Jesus.
Yes. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Every witch doctor monitoring my destiny.
Don't talk with me.
Can you say it with fire? Dry up in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Father, we thank you for a time like this.
Baba dupe lowo yin firu akoko
bayi. And we thank you for your grace and power upon our lives.
Asi dupe fun ore ofe ati agbara yin lori aye wa.
Lord, open our understanding.
Oluwa eshi wa loye.
Father, speak unto us.
Baba ba wa soro.
Help us, Lord,
ero wa lowo Oluwa
to fulfill our destiny.
Lati mu ayanmo wa se.
Father, we stand against
Baba aduro lodi si
any arrow fired against families.
Offer to what ta lodi si awon idile.
The arrows of disunity.
Offer I niche okan.
The arrows of disloyalty.
Offer I je olotito.
The arrows of bitterness.
Awon fa ikoro.
Fired into any family, fired into any home.
Don't tassel you more. Let be don't tassel.
We command them to backfire in the name of
Jesus. Aliya se kon ta pada ni oruko Jesus.
Lay your hands upon all of us. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Let's sit down.
In
Jesus' name. Today is the third Sunday as usual. Where we answer a few questions. On marriage and home. But before we go into the question session, I want to share just a little bit with you before we go on. In Leviticus, chapter 26, verse
29,
we read a strange verse. Leviticus
26,
39. Please listen to this short message very well. So you can know where to direct your prayers. Leviticus 26. Verse 39. And they that are left of you shall pine away
ati awon ti o ku ninu yin ni yo joro ninu
in their iniquity
ninu ese won
in your enemy's lands
ni ile awon ta yin
and also
ati nitori
in the iniquities of their fathers
ese awon baba won pelu
shall they pine away with them
ni wo ma joro pelu won
two iniquities
awon ese dede meji
their own personal iniquity
will
sponsor their wastage. Then the iniquity of their father's house
too
will also sponsor their wastage. Your marriage and your ancestry. Your marriage and your ancestry. Listen to this very short message. Your marriage or your home is of interest to heaven. Your marriage or your home is also of interest to hellfire. Both angels are and demons are interested in your home. The enemy hates godly homes with perfect hatred. The enemy hates godly marriages with perfect hatred. So the enemy can go to any length to cause confusion or to destabilize any home. It is therefore a big tragedy when the enemy is the one pressing the remote control button and father did not realize, mother did not realize, children too are not aware that somewhere behind the scene there is a dark evil manipulating and controlling. And so couples fight it out when they should have combined together to fight a common enemy. One terrible power
agbara kan to buru jai
that has mesmerized and confused homes
o ti darudulu sile ninu opolopo idile
is ancestral powers
o ni awon agbara ati iran di iran
ancestral powers
awon agbara ati iran di iran
are powers that you inherited.
Won ji awon agbara ti ojogun bi enikan.
A platform prepared for you by your ancestors.
Ipele kan ti awon baba nla re ti pese sile fun o.
And whether we like it or not.
Boyo wa wu wa tabi ko wu wa.
Every man, every woman is a product of all his or her ancestors.
Gbogbo okunrin tabi obirin won ji abajade awon baba nla won.
This platform prepared for our ancestors is a more serious problem than we think.
Ipele ti awon baba nla pese sile fun wa e o je to le
it requires serious violence in prayers.
Onilo adura to ni ipa ninu.
It is a serious problem.
Isoro nla lo je.
It requires violence.
Onilo ikonra
asipa. Some come complaining to us.
Awon kan wa awa kominu pelu wa.
Since I married this person, then everything has become upside down. It's the fault of the person I married.
No. Pe lati gba ti mo ti fe lagbaja ni kan ti dori kodo ebi eni ti mo fe ni.
Now. You don't understand. You should check the platform from which you are coming. So your ancestry can pollute, can defile, can trouble, can harass, can torment, can molest, can rape your home and your marriage. Here lies a great problem that many couples don't realize. It is time for people to sit down and begin to think and meditate deeply on these matters. Many are merely fighting the devils that fought their parents' marriages in their own marriage too. People who come from polygamous home tend to become polygamous themselves unless they are prayerful.
Àwọn tó wá láti ìdílé akóbìnrin jọ, àwọn gan dàgbà wọn máa kóbìnrin jọ pé kò ṣe pé wọn bá ṣọ́ra.
People where they bash the mother, they are always bashing your mother. They tend to become bashed in their own marriages too, unless they take care.
Àwọn tó wá láti ìdílé tí wọ́n ti ń nà ìyàwó gẹ́gẹ́ bí ẹni nù ẹrú, àwọn náà tó bá dàgbà tó bá ṣọ́ra, wọ́n á máa nù àwọn náà.
If you come from a family where they worship idol,
tẹ bá wá láti inú ìdílé tí wọ́n ti ń bo òrìṣà.
Don't be surprised if you find that heaven is closing on top of that marriage. If you begin to notice frustration, disappointment, instead of fighting yourself, you should sit down and deal with that foundation of idol worship. Idols have no interest in marriages or good homes.
Ọ̀rọ̀ ìgbéyàwó tàbí ìdílé rere kò wún àwọn òrìṣà rárá.
Idol is a monogamous power.
Ìbọ̀rìṣà ó di agbára ti ìkópinrin jọ.
It's not interested in people coming together to start praying.
Kò wún lárárá káwọn èèyàn kóra jọ pé láti máa gba àdúrà.
So do you come from families where they worship idol?
Ẹ̀hà wá láti inú ìdílé tí wọ́n ti ń bo òrìṣà
bí. I will not be surprised if your marriage is going through very stressful times now.
Kò lè yà mí lẹ́nu pé ìgbéyàwó yìí ó ń la lásìkò kọjá
nísìnyí. Serious challenges. If that is where you come from. That's why I said your marriage and your ancestry. If you come from a family where they practice masquerading,
then
don't be too surprised if that home is unstable now, or there is stagnancy in that home, or there is a coverage, a veil on the marriage. Nobody blesses them. They don't get breakthroughs. Their visions are blinded. Simply because a masquerade is someone who is wearing a mask. You don't see the real person. It's the mask that you see.
So
the marriage has become a masquerade marriage. I'm praying for any home here today where it is your foundation that is troubling you, that you must receive your deliverance in the name of Jesus. Polygamy. You come from a foundation ancestry of polygamy. And then you are complaining that the husband is cheating. That complaint will get nowhere. What you need to do is to intervene in prayers. When people come from polygamous setup, they have this anointing to jilt women. They have this anointing of sexual weakness. They have this anointing of pursuing anything that is wearing skirts. They have this anointing of wanting to sample any woman or any man they see They carry out random samples. And when they sample and they collect HIV, they transfer it back to the woman at home. They have this peck and go spirit. Have you come from a polygamous home? And things are rough in that home now. And you are finding disloyalty, infidelity, all kinds of things like that. Fighting. Boxing, reporting to A, reporting to B, is not the solution. The solution is deliverance. So get on your knees and pray whatever person is responsible out of the bondage of polygamy. I want to pray one prayer now. Even if you don't feel you are concerned, I recommend you say a loud amen. Father, I'm praying right now.
That
anyone who's been troubled by polygamous witchcraft in any part of their lives, I command them to receive their deliverance in them. Let that amen roar like thunder. Which doctors? You look back. You find that your father was a native doctor. You noticed. You see that anointing in your family. Then you should know there is something to do. Bow down your heads where you are. Shout this prayer louder than anyone around you. Don't say it doesn't concern me. Say, dark platform. Prepared by my ancestors for me. Scatter in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and decree. Then we pray. Perhaps your father was a witch doctor. And sometimes they bring mad women, troubled women, to him for healing. He heals them satanically and marries them, multiplying wives. If that is where you are coming from, that's the foundation from which you are coming, then don't be surprised. If right now your home is going through constant failure, consistent attacks, don't be surprised. And if you are a single person, you are not married yet, don't be surprised. If the kind of men that are running after you are occultic men and evil men, because of that foundation from which you have come. And if you don't pay attention, that's a problem. And then you are fighting shadows instead of fighting the evil foundation that has been battling you. We had a case.
A ni oro kan.
Long time ago before the mantle of fire miracles ministry was started by God.
Lopo igba ko to di pe Olorun kile ori oke nu ati se iya.
In the church where I was that time.
Ni jo ti mo man lo ni igba na.
There was a witch doctor who had this shop not too far from our church.
Ada won se kan wa to je pe ile re ojina si ile isin wa.
I think he had healed a young lady of, he already had 4 wives.
O ti ni iyawo merin.
He had healed a young lady of insanity.
O wa wo obirin kan san kuro ninu arun were.
When they brought the young lady mad.
Nigba kan gbe odobirin na wa sodo re to sinwin.
He told them,
o so fun won.
If I heal her, I marry her.
To ba gba iwosan won fe niyawo.
The parents said no problem, just heal her.
Awon bi re se pe ko si wahala nsa je ko ri iwosan.
So he healed this lady.
Nipa bayi ara obirin ya.
And then
leyin yi
confided her to a wife.
O so di iyawo le.
The wife now began to come to church.
Iyawo wa bere si wa si ile Olorun.
This lady number 5.
Iyen ni iyawo kan
began to come to our church.
Gbiyanju won wa si ijo wa.
She began to pray.
O bere si gbadura.
She began to understand the word of God.
Oyi oro Olorun si bere si ye.
And so she kept challenging the native doctor at home.
Nipa be o ma koju ija si baba lawo to wa ni ile yi.
That I'm getting out of here.
Emi o jade kuro ninu ile.
I'm not supposed to be here.
O ye kin wa ni.
Number 1, number 2, number 3, number 4. They're not satisfied. What do you want to do to a small girl like me?
Oni yawo kini keji keta kerin. Ki lo fe fi odo mo ni bi emi se.
I think the man must have consulted his oracle.
O da den pe okunrin ti ye opele re.
And the fact that it was the church that was responsible.
O wa kiyesi pe ijo ti ranse bi na nlo.
He therefore came to church and asked to see me.
O wa so pe ohun fe ri mi.
So I say yes.
No ya.
So are you the man here?
So yin ni okunrin to wa nihin.
So by the grace of God.
Ni kore of your
Lord. Look.
Kiyesi.
I am not disturbing you.
Mi o yo lenu.
So you don't disturb me.
Ni baba iwo na ma yo mi lenu.
My wife is coming to this church.
Iyawo mi ma nwa si ile ijosin ni.
Tell her not to come again.
So fun ko ma wa si bi bayi mo.
And if she continues coming,
to ba si wa tesi wa to nwa si yin,
I will fight you.
Wo ba oja.
I said fight.
Oni ja.
Say sir,
alaga.
What kind of fight?
Iru ija wo?
Zi judo.
Se ija judo ni.
Zi karate.
Se ija karate ni.
Zi boxing.
Se ije ise kikan ni.
Zi wrestling.
Se ija fife mi me.
He said no. None of those things.
It's
spiritual.
Only that you mean.
I said, well done. Yes.
That's
why we should fight it.
Iru ija to ye ka ja niyan.
Is that okay?
Ono da.
You will see.
O rio.
We folded him up in 2 weeks.
Ni ani ose meji ati pale re mo.
Just pointing to the place.
Pe a kan na ka sibe ni.
He ran away.
O sa lo ni.
That's what set that lady free.
Oh, to so pretty.
If that kind of native doctor was your father.
To ba ye ko ru baba lawo be lo bi o ni omo.
I know you are married.
O wa de en to think pe ti pe yawo ba.
You will be having demonic magnet to go and get more women.
Awon fati e mi oku ka ma fa o ko lo fe yawo si.
If you are from a marine worship foundation.
To ba ye pe ninu ipile ton tin bo awon ye moja bi awon eya omi.
Your mother's worship waters.
Awon iya re omi ni won bo.
You are from riverine area.
Lati inu agbegbe ti ese odo lo ti wa.
As a rule.
Gege bi ilanu.
It takes the grace of God and the power of God for marriages of people from riverine areas to succeed.
O ni lori ofe Olorun ati agbara Olorun.
Because there is a ridge from the bottom of the waters where sometimes technically all the men on the land have been married to some spirits in the water.
Nitori pe irunu awon emi to wa labi omi ma nsele ti e ba wo finifini gbogbo awon okunrin to wa nibe na ti fe yawo pelu awon eda to ti iru mi wa.
They don't take marriage seriously.
Tori na e fowo do ina mo re pe yawo.
They just jump from woman to woman.
O kon be latodo obirin kan si omiran.
The woman too don't think is anything serious if they are sleeping around.
Awon obirin gan won fowo do ina mo re pe yawo won kan
si. So if you come from that kind of marine foundation.
To ba ye pe ninu ipele omi be le ti wa.
Don't be surprised.
E ma je ko ya yin lenu.
If you find that the husband, the wife you marry has now become very wicked.
And
like it happens in all riverine sections, sexually loose.
Don't
be surprised if there is multiple sexual partners that
they are running after. So these
are ways
in
which your ancestry can affect your marriage. We need to go and answer the question. So I'm going to stop here. Later we'll go back to this one. And I continue telling you the relationship between the foundation from which you are coming and the kind of marriages that you are having or attacks on your home. And if you are married and you are still dreaming that you are marrying somebody else. You are dreaming that your shoes are missing. You are dreaming of masquerades. You are dreaming of marketplaces. There's an attack against that marriage. You are dreaming of losing your shoes, losing your wedding garment. You are dreaming of marketplaces. Or wearing torn clothes. It is evidence that there is a platform working against you. Close your eyes where you are
now.
Close your eyes where you are. Before we go into the question sessions, there is a prayer I want you to pray like thunder and like fire. Everybody remain standing. It's not the kind of prayer you pray sitting down. It's a prayer you pray standing up and with fire and with power. Let your voice roar like fire and like thunder. As you shout this loud and clear. Arrows! Fired by my foundation. Into my home. Can I hear you shouting this loud? Let your voice be louder than this. Let your voice still be louder than that. In the name of Jesus.
It is another wonderful question and answer session on our monthly family forum. It is a moment where you tell it to Jesus. And as you gather with your families before the Lord, determined to tell it all to Jesus this morning, your story will change. And Jesus will again be glorified in your house and homes. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. The first question, and I want you to listen very carefully. It reads those an international program was held in this Lagos for single, and a question was asked that what is love? So some stood up and said, love is when a man beat his wife.
Àwọn kan dìde, wọ́n wí pé ìfẹ́ gan ni nígbà tí ọkùnrin kan bá na ìyàwó rẹ̀.
And draw her close to her immediately.
Tó tún wá tún fà á mọ́ra lójú ẹsẹ̀.
Plenty people supported her.
Ọgọ́rọ̀ ènìyàn gan ló wá sọ wípé ẹun tẹni náà sọ bẹ́ẹ̀ lórí.
That she is right.
Wípé ẹni tó dáhùn ìbéèrè ọ̀hún wípé ó jẹ́ ohun tí ó tọ̀nà.
I know people like that will be here today.
Mo mọ̀ wípé irúfẹ́ àwọn ni bí eléyìí wọ́n máa wà níbí lónìí.
Please explain what love is to them.
Ẹ jọ̀wọ́ ẹ ṣàlàyé ohun tí ìtumọ̀ ìfẹ́ tó jẹ́ fún wọn.
Praise God.
Okay, hallelujah.
We must be very careful about this question.
A ní láti kíyèsára púpọ̀ nípa ìbéèrè yìí.
This should not be quoted out of context.
Kò yẹ kí a máa sọ ìtumọ̀ eléyìí nínú ìtumọ̀ rẹ̀ gan.
We believe it is a figurative way of explaining or describing a person.
A mọ̀ wípé ó jẹ́ ọ̀nà àpèjúwe tí a fi lè ṣàkàwé ènìyàn.
Who is humble enough to recognize his fault?
Ẹni tí ó ní ìrẹ̀lẹ̀ tó láti mọ àwọn ẹ̀bí rẹ̀.
And take immediate step.
Yóò sì wá gbé ìgbésẹ̀ lójú ẹsẹ̀.
To make amend.
Láti lè ṣe àtúnṣe.
Particularly by apologizing.
Pàápàá jùlọ nípa títọrọ àforíjì.
That is what that figuratively is expressing.
Ohun tí ìṣe àpèjúwe yìí tí ó ń ṣe àfihàn rẹ̀
rèé. It should be clear that slapping is not expected in Christian marriage anyway.
Ó yẹ kí a mọ̀ wípé gbígbanilétí kì í ṣe ohun tí a gbọ́dọ̀ máa rí nínú ìgbéyàwó Kristẹni.
If you consider the constraint that we have in 1 Peter 3:7.
Bí a bá ṣe àgbéyẹ̀wò ohun tí a ní nínú ìwé Pétérù kìíní orí kẹta ẹsẹ̀ keje.
That describe woman as weak.
Èyí tí ó ṣàkàwé àwọn obìnrin gẹ́gẹ́ bí ohun èlò tí kò ní agbára.
Now I will define love.
Wàyí wọ́n wá sọ ìtumọ̀ ìfẹ́.
I will refer you to 1 Corinthians 13:1-7.
Wọ́n sì fẹ́ kí a ṣí bíbélì wa sí ìwé Kọ́rìntì kìíní orí kẹtàlá láti ẹsẹ̀ kẹrin sí ìkẹjọ.
I won't read it all.
O ní ká gbogbo rẹ̀.
It says charity suffereth long.
Ó wí pé ìfẹ́ a máa mú sùúrù.
And is kind.
A sì máa ṣeun.
Charity envieth not.
Ìfẹ́ kìí ṣe ìlara.
Charity vaunteth not itself.
Ìfẹ́ kìí sọ̀rọ̀ ìgbéraga.
And is not puffed up.
Bẹ́ẹ̀ ni kìí fẹ́.
Praise God.
Okay, hallelujah.
Now in summary.
Ní àkójọpọ̀ lórèfé.
Love is the ability to serve one another.
Ìfẹ́ gan ni pa kí a lè máa sin ara wa.
It is a sacrificial servanthood.
Ó jẹ́ ìṣe ọmọlẹ́yìn èyí tí ènìyàn ń fi ara rẹ̀ gbúgbọ́.
As recorded in Galatians 5:13.
Gẹ́gẹ́ bí a ṣe kọ àkọsílẹ̀ rẹ̀ nínú Galatians 5:13.
Love is bringing out the best in other person.
Ìfẹ́ ni mímú eléyìí tí ó dára jùlọ jáde nínú ayé ẹlòmíràn.
It is selfless venture into other person.
Ó jẹ́ ìṣe àìwo ti ara ẹni nínú ìgbé ayé ẹlòmíràn.
Into other person's life.
Sí inú ìgbé ayé ẹlòmíràn.
Into your spouse.
Nípa titi ọkọ tàbí aya yín.
It will remain a service.
Ó jẹ́ ìsìn, ó dúró gẹ́gẹ́ bí ìsìn síbẹ̀.
To other person.
Fún ẹlòmíràn.
So that is as far as that is concerned, the brother wants to know what love is. So you are in the ministry of service to the Lord.
Fún ẹni tó fẹ́ mọ ohun tí ìtumọ̀ ìfẹ́ jẹ́, ẹ wà nínú iṣẹ́ sísin ara ẹni.
Now the next question is, my husband said that anytime he had sex.
Ìbéèrè kejì ni pé ọkọ mi wípé ní gbogbo ìgbà tí àwọn bá ní ìbálòpọ̀.
With me.
Tó bá ní ìbálòpọ̀ pẹ̀lú mi.
He normally has an attack in the dream.
Ó máa ń ní ìgbóguntì ní ojú oorun.
From some men.
Látọ̀dọ̀ àwọn ọkùnrin kan.
And he asks me to go for deliverance.
Ó sọ fún mi pé kí n lọ ṣe ìtúsílẹ̀.
But I accused him of not having enough fun.
Àmọ́ mo máa ń fi ẹ̀sùn kan wípé kì í ṣe ẹni tó mo eré ṣe tó.
Enough fund.
Ẹni tí kò mọ bí a ti ń ṣe.
I would have gone for the deliverance.
Mi ò bá ti lọ fún ìtúsílẹ̀.
But I am so busy because I am a school teacher.
Ó ní ṣùgbọ́n iṣẹ́ pọ̀ púpọ̀ lọ́wọ́ mi torí olùkọ́ ni mo jẹ́.
But now I am ready to go for deliverance.
Àmọ́ wàyí o, mo ti ṣetán láti lọ fún ìtúsílẹ̀.
And he refused to give me money.
Àmọ́ ó kọ̀ láti fún mi lówó.
To go because I told him my sister wanted to get married.
Nítorí mo sọ fún pé arábìnrin mi fẹ́ ṣe ìgbéyàwó.
Listen carefully. And I have paid 35,000 for the wedding attire.
Bẹ́ẹ̀ni mo ti san owó tó fẹ́ fi ṣe ìgbéyàwó ẹgbẹ̀rún lọ́nà.
My question is that
ogójì.
Am I doing right with my action? What can I do? Because he has separated birth with me. Hallelujah. My sister, you have not addressed the issue of your husband's reported spiritual attack on the bed with the seriousness and priority that it derives. And so, you have raised doubt in your man as regards your right priority or not.
He
cannot see the genuineness of your concern for what he is going through. I don't know your financial strength of your husband, but I guess you must have saved towards, you know, having transport fare to prayer city or wherever you want to do deliverance. You should have saved some money from this ashebi or wedding attire.
Oh yeah, if you would pamo nino ashebi tabi or ashebeya, what's your fair ye?
The stability and health of your primary home is more important. Your husband may have developed some fear or phobia on your matrimonial bed. His greater fear is not the attack he has on the bed, but your very questionable and weak response to what he might have considered as life-threatening to him. You must therefore prayerfully reorder your priorities.
And
this will influence a change in the mindset of your husband. Praise God. And the last question on this round. I'm married, unmarried. My father called me and said my mother is his greatest problem. That he wants my mother to be totally submissive. I am surprised after 34 years of marriage. Please, sir, what will be my advice? Because everyone, it's one fight or the other, and it's beginning to affect the children. This question is so important because it affects the soul of home. In Ephesians, the book of Ephesians, you will see that a role is attached to each member of, a role is attached to every member of the home.
The husband.
Yes. For children.
For a woman.
God said you must be obedient, but beyond that, you must be able to support home with your own prayer as a Christian that you are.
Pẹ̀lú àdúrà yín àti gẹ́gẹ́ bí Kristẹni ẹ jẹ́ ẹgbọ́dọ̀ lọ máa ṣe àtìlẹyìn fún ilé yín pẹ̀lú àdúrà.
You may think that you are too young to intervene in 34-year-old marriage.
Ẹ lè wá máa lérò wípé bóyá o ti kéré jù láti dá sí ìgbéyàwó ọdún 24.
You may think so.
Ẹ lè máa lérò bẹ́ẹ̀.
From your submission in this question,
àmọ́ nínú ohun tí ẹ sọ nípa ìbéèrè yìí,
It appears your father may have some level of confidence in you. And is looking forward to that solution. Our advice is this. Go to God in prayer for revelation. And subsequently approach any of your parents. To obtain the reason for the cause of misunderstanding between them.
Láti mo èrèje ohun tó ń fa ìjà láàrin àwọn méjèèjì.
I know the Lord will be faithful.
Mo mọ̀ wípé Olúwa yóò jẹ́ olótìtọ́.
And I pray that he will use you.
Mo sì gbàdúrà wípé yóò lò yín.
Alternatively, you can encourage both of your parents or one of them as God reveals for a counseling assistance at our office, Happy Home. God bless you as you do this in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
The first question.
Ibere akoko.
Ejowo elami loye.
Please enlighten me.
Emi je omodun moko din ni adon rin.
I am 69 years old.
Oko mi si je omodun adon rin.
My husband is 70 years old.
Sugbon ibalopo ma fa ija laarin wa.
But sexual intercourse always brings grievance between us.
Ojo meta meta lo ma sumo mi.
He always meets me every other day. 3 days.
O si ti sumi.
And I am tired.
Mo si ti be titi.
I have begged him enough.
Ko gba fun mi.
He did not allow me.
O si mo pe mo ni eje ruru.
And you know I am an high blood pressure patient.
Ati ito sugar.
And diabetics.
Igba kigba ti mo ba ti gba.
Anytime that I disallowed him,
o man shekpe fun mi.
He always cursed me.
Ara mi ko si gba ibalopo ojo meta mo.
And my body did not allow this sexual intercourse of 3 days.
O ti sun mi o.
I am tired.
Mama to ko iwe yi.
This woman that wrote this letter.
E jowo keruwa kia kia.
Please see us quickly.
Leyin ipade yi.
After this service.
God bless you.
Oluwa yo bukun yin.
Question 2.
Ibere keji.
A man who could not pay his house rent.
Okunrin ti o le san owo ile.
And the wife decided to support him.
Iyawo si gbiyanju lati ma ran lowo.
By giving the money to him.
Lati ma fun ni owo yen.
But this man would spend out of this money again.
Sugbon okunrin yi nse lo ma tun na ninu owo yi.
Without telling the woman.
Lai so fun obirin yi.
So the sister is saying, what can I do?
Now, arabirin yen wa nbere wi pe kini ki ohun ki o se.
3 things.
Ohun meta.
Number 1.
Akoko.
Prayer.
Adura.
You must pray.
O gbodo gbadura.
That God will help that man.
Pe ki Olorun ki o ran okunrin yen lowo.
To rediscover himself.
Lati le se awari ara re.
And to also pray more.
Ki o si tun gbadura siwaju si.
That the Lord will bless him.
Pe ki Olorun ki o bukun.
Number 2.
Ikeji.
You have to show love.
O gbodo fi ife han.
Because when you marry a man.
Nitori ngba ti o ba fe oko.
Or a woman.
Tabi obirin.
You marry all the assets and the liabilities.
Gbogbo wahala ti lasi inawo nora re ohun lo fe.
All the positives and the negatives.
Gbogbo o barade ati ko barade.
All the kelegs.
Gbogbo awawi to wa nbe.
And the straight things there.
Ohun to si wa nbe ni pe.
So you need love.
O nilo ife.
To be patient.
Lati ni suru.
To be patient.
Lati ni suru.
Then you also must not be getting angry with him.
Ni obo siwaju si o gbodo ma baja tabi binu si.
Then the third thing you need quickly.
Keta to nilo.
Wisdom. Wisdom. When you have the money, apply the wisdom to go and pay it directly. And the second aspect of the wisdom, when you are paying the money to the landlord, don't do it such a way to run down your husband. God bless you. The third question quickly. Say, what can a man or a woman do?
Kini okunrin tabi obirin le se?
A young man or a young girl?
Obirin odo tabi okunrin odo?
When your parents are insisting that you must marry from your tribe.
Nigbati awon obi re fi oko ọ̀ràn yàn sí pé àwọn ẹ̀yà yín ló gbọ́dọ̀ ti fẹ́ ìyàwó.
And there's no one proposing to you from that tribe.
Kò sì sí ẹnikẹ́ni tó dẹnu kọ́ láti ẹ̀yà yín yẹn wá.
A brother is interested in an Edo sister.
Arákùnrin ó fẹ́ràn láti fẹ́ ẹnìkan ló wá láti Edo.
But the father who is an Urobo man.
Ṣùgbọ́n bàbá tó jẹ́ pé láti Urobo ni ó ti wá.
He's saying no.
Ó wí pé rárá o.
That the brother must marry from Urobo.
Àwọn ará Urobo ni ó gbọ́dọ̀ fẹ́.
And this father.
Bàbá yìí.
Is also an MFM member.
Ó sì jẹ́ ọmọ orí òkè náà tí ẹ̀yà ni.
And he's saying.
Ó sì ń wí pé.
That there's a kind of covenant.
Pé irun májẹ̀mú kan wà.
Between him.
Láàrin òun.
And his late wife.
Àti ìyàwó òun tó ti ṣolóògbé.
That none of their children.
Pé kò sí èyíkéyìí inú ọmọ àwọn.
Must marry from another tribe.
Tí ó gbọ́dọ̀ fẹ́yàwó tàbí lọ́kọ láti ẹ̀yà mìíràn.
So if these children want to marry, if these children want to marry from another tribe.
Nítorí náà tí àwọn ọmọ yẹn bá fẹ́ wá fẹ́. Ní ẹ̀yà mìíràn.
They must go to the grave.
Wọ́n gbọ́dọ̀ lọ sí ibi ibojì.
Bring out their mummy.
Kí wọ́n mú màmá wọn jáde.
So that they can break the covenant.
Kí wọ́n ba lè fọ májẹ̀mú yẹn.
Then they are free.
Ìgbà náà ni wọ́n tó yẹ̀bọ́.
That is the problem here.
Wàhálà tó wà níbẹ̀ nìyẹn.
Two things.
Ohun méjì.
The first thing I will mention.
Ohun àkọ́kọ́ ta mẹ́nuba.
In Galatians chapter 3 verse 28.
Nínú ìwé Galatia orí kẹta ẹsẹ̀ kejì.
The Bible says in Christ Jesus.
Bíbélì sọ pé nínú Jésù Kristì.
There is no Jew or Gentile.
Kò sí Jew, kò sì sí kẹfẹ́rì.
No male or female.
Kò sí ọkùnrin àbí obìnrin.
No bond or free.
Kò sí òǹdè tàbí òǹtúsílẹ̀.
That we are all one in Christ Jesus.
Pé gbogbo wa ọ̀kan náà ni wá nínú Kristì.
So in Christ Jesus.
Torí náà nínú Kristì Jésù.
There is no tribal segregation.
Kò sí ẹlẹ́yàmẹ̀yà.
That's the first thing you must understand.
Eléyìí ni ohun àkọ́kọ́ tẹ gbọ́dọ̀ jẹ́ kó yẹ yín.
Then the second thing.
Ìkejì.
That it is good that the old man is a member of this ministry.
Ó tiẹ̀ da pé àbá yìí. Ó jẹ́ ọmọ orí òkè náà tí ẹ̀yà
wọn. And we have been taught that there is no covenant that the blood of Jesus cannot break.
A sì mọ̀ wípé òun náà wọ́n ti gba ìdálẹ́kọ̀ọ́ pé kò sí májẹ̀mú tí Ọlọ́run ò lè fọ́.
The Bible says.
Bíbélì wípé.
Can the prey be taken from a lawful captive?
Pé ǹjẹ́ a lè gba òǹdè kúrò lọ́wọ́ òǹdè rẹ̀.
Can the prey be taken from the mighty?
Àní ǹjẹ́ a lè gba òǹdè kúrò lọ́wọ́ alágbára?
Or a lawful captive delivered?
Tàbí kí a tú òǹdè sílẹ̀.
So the Lord will help you.
Ọlọ́run yóò ràn yín lọ́wọ́.
You need to invite your daddy.
O nílò láti pe bàbá rẹ.
To see our pastors.
Láti rí àwọn olùṣọ́ àgùntàn wa.
For counseling.
Fún ìmọ̀ràn.
So they can be guided through.
Kí wọ́n ba lè tọ́ wọn sọ́nà.
Deliverance.
Fún ìtúsílẹ̀.
I mean every member of the family.
Àní gbogbo mọ̀lẹ́bí yín.
So that covenant can be broken.
Kí gbogbo májẹ̀mú náà ba lè di fífọ́.
Amen.
Àmì.
The last question here.
Kókó ìbéèrè tó gbẹ̀yìn.
I am in a relationship with a man.
Mo wà ní ìwọléwọ̀de pẹ̀lú ọkùnrin kan.
But he is not a graduate.
Ṣùgbọ́n kì í ṣe ẹni tó ti jáde university.
But the Lord is leading me.
Ṣùgbọ́n Ọlọ́run tó ń darí mi.
He has confirmed it to me.
Ó ti fi yé mi.
That I should marry.
Pé kí n fẹ́.
But the man is not a graduate.
Ṣùgbọ́n ọkùnrin kì í ṣe ẹni tó ti jáde university.
But he also has something he's doing.
Ṣùgbọ́n ó ní ohun kan tó ń ṣe.
My sister.
Arábìnrin.
If you are listening to me.
Tó bá ń gbọ́ mi.
Listen very well.
Gbọ́ mi dáadáa.
You have settled the case yourself.
Ìwọ náà o ti yanjú ọ̀rọ̀ yẹn fúnra rẹ.
That the Lord is leading you.
Pé Ọlọ́run darí rẹ.
So if the Lord is leading you.
Tí Ọlọ́run bá wá ń darí rẹ.
The best thing to say.
Ohun tó da láti sọ.
Is yes sir.
Òhun ni pé bẹ́ẹ̀ ni Olúwa
mi. Also know.
Àní kò sì mọ̀ bákan náà.
That the primary thing you must consider in any relationship.
Pé ohun àkọ́kọ́ tó gbọ́dọ̀ fi sọ́kàn nínú gbogbo ìwọléwọ̀de.
Is what the Lord is saying.
Òhun ni
what the Lord is saying.
Òhun ni ohun tí Ọlọ́run sọ.
And you must know.
O sì gbọ́dọ̀ mọ̀.
That is written in Isaiah 46 verse 10.
Pé gẹ́gẹ́ bí a ṣe kọ́ nínú ìwé Isaiah orí kẹtàléníàádọ́ta ẹsẹ̀
kẹwàá. That the Lord knows the end of everything from the beginning.
Pé Ọlọ́run mọ òpin ohun gbogbo láti ìbẹ̀rẹ̀ rẹ̀.
Jeremiah 29 verse 11 says.
Jeremiah orí kọkàndínlọ́gbọ̀n ẹsẹ̀ ìkọkànlá
náà wípé. I know the thoughts that are for you.
Èmi mọ èrò mi fún yín.
The thought of good.
Àní èrò àlàáfíà.
Not of evil.
Kì í ṣe fún ibi.
To give you an expected end.
Láti fún ọ ní ìrètí ayọ̀.
It is better for you my sister.
Ó dára fún arábìnrin mi.
To marry an uneducated man.
Láti fẹ́ kúrúntù ẹ̀dá.
Who will treat you as a queen.
Ẹni tí yóò kẹ́ ọ gẹ́gẹ́ bí aya ọba.
That to marry a graduate.
Ju pé kí o kọ́ kí o fẹ́ ẹni tó kẹ́kọ̀ọ́ gboyè.
That will treat you as a slave.
Tí yóò máa darí rẹ tàbí kẹ́ ọ gẹ́gẹ́ bí ẹrú.
It's better to marry a man.
Ó dára láti fẹ́ ọkọ.
who cannot speak English. And we're giving you your food. Thinking of you. That to marry a man who is highly sophisticated, but you cannot have anything to show for it. The Lord has spoken. Take step. And you will not regret in Jesus' name. God bless you.
Praise the Lord. I have three questions here. The first question says, sir, you said a husband should not report his wife to his family. Or to his mother-in-law. When she does something bad, my wife is the type that does not listen. In whatever I am saying. Immediately I want to tell her or correct her on something that she has done wrong. She will just shun me and walk out. The only person that she listened to is our mother. The question is it not better to report her to her mother? The only person she can listen to. Instead of engaging her in a fight. I have tried all means. To no avail. It's what she decides to do. That she will do. My brother. I want to thank God for your life. You have really shown here that you are a mature husband. Recognize this fact. That your wife is not another man like you. Do not struggle to refashion her as a man like you. I counsel you not to go to her mother and report her, assuming the mother is not readily available. So I want to counsel you that you take this challenge to God in prayer. Moreover, remember, you are no longer two, but one. If you start reporting her, it means you have invited a third party. According to what you have been told, in Matthew 19:4-6, Jesus told us there, they are no longer two, but one. You must be in harmony with your wife. Pray for her always. And gently, patiently, and spiritually, nurture her to the will of God. Both of you. Woman, be submissive. Be submissive. You are a wife. Because God has made you to be a female. Your husband cannot be like you. In every way. You think and you feel. Not because she does not want to care. Or want to be, it is because he's a male. Don't ever shun your husband and walk out on him. God bless you in Jesus' name. Another question. Good morning, sir. Please, I got a girl pregnant while in my final year in school. Because of fear, I couldn't accept that she
abort the pregnancy.
Mo fa egba koko lo se oyun na.
Now my family is aware.
Niba yi awon molebi mi ti mo si.
And my son is 1 year 2 months old.
Omo mi okunrin si ti pe odun kan ati osu meji.
I don't know what to do.
Mi o mo ohun ti mo ma se.
Because I have not paid the bride price.
Tori pe mo ti san owo ori.
And I love her unconditionally.
Mo de mo si nife re gidigidi.
She tells me.
O so fun mi.
She does not know.
Pe won mo.
If she can wait.
So ba le duro
to marry me.
Lati le fe mi.
And I don't want to lose her.
Mo si fe padanu re.
Not because of that son.
Ko se nitori omokunrin yo.
But because I love her still.
Sugbon tori pe mo si ni fere sile.
Please, I need your advice.
E jowo mo nilo imoran
yin. I am confused.
O ti o so o polukuru mu su si mi.
Amen.
Amen.
My brother.
Ara
first and foremost.
Lakoko na.
You are a fornicator.
O je alagbere.
You must first seek for forgiveness from God. Seriously repent. And also forsake all unrighteousness. You and that lady, you are only digging the pit of hell. I'll counsel you that both of you should go to God in prayer. Thank God that you say you love her unconditionally. But the two of you must go and rededicate your life to God. With all seriousness. And know the purpose of God for the two of you. And I thank God for you again. That you, for you to love her unconditionally. Please confirm it with prayer. But if you, the love is from God. And I am sure. God will make her to wait for you to marry
ha.
Praise the Lord. The third question is this. Number one. This is 2 in 1. One. What if your husband left the burden for the wife alone? What will the wife do? This is the 15 times of paying children's school fees, paying house rent, also feeding the family, and other things that are needed in the family. My sister, I want to answer this question by asking some questions here. And this question will lead us to what to do. Why is your husband not able to support you financially? Does your husband work? The Bible tells us clearly that a man needs to work. Proverbs 10:4, 2 Thessalonians 3:10, and 1 Timothy 5:8 tells us this. Does your husband work but have a low paying job? Is it possible to get a pay rise by getting another job? Note this. With the economy in the country now, it usually takes 2 incomes to support a family. But if a man has a job and is not supporting that family, that man is worse than an infidel. That is what we are told in 1 Timothy 5:8. On the other hand, if he has a job and he has tried genuinely By all means.
So that it be on journey book burner.
To get one.
Lati ri kan se.
Sorry, if he has no job.
Ṣugbọn ti ko ba wa ri ise.
And he has tried by all means.
So ba ti gbiyanju ni gbogbo ona.
Genuinely.
Lọna to tọ.
To get this job.
Lati le ri ise ise.
And could not.
Ti ko si ri ise ise.
Please my sister.
E jọwọ arabinrin mi.
Still continue to support him.
Tẹsiwaju lati ma ran lọwọ.
Still continue to support him.
E tẹsiwaju lati ma ran.
Remember.
E ranti o.
Hard times. Hard times does not last. But tough people last. My brother, if you have a job, a good job, please support your family. Don't be an infidel, but a true child of God. And the two of you should always pray together. And always call God on what you want God to do daily. I believe definitely that God will answer your prayers. You will eat the fruit of your labor in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Thank you, hallelujah.
We have three questions here. The first one is, sir, please, if a man paid the dowry of a woman, and it happened that on the day of their wedding, the man did not come to the wedding. And the wife decided to quit the marriage and marry another man. Sir, as a believer, is it right for the woman to go and marry another man? If you look well at this question, there was no wedding. Though he has paid the dowry, which can be refunded since he failed to come for proper joining before the altar of God. And I want you to know that we have three types of marriage in Nigeria. The first one is the traditional wedding. And the second one is the court marriage. The third one is the church wedding. This woman did not tell us if the man did the court with the dowry. But he just said he paid the dowry. And they were not lawfully joined together. So, there is nothing binding the woman from remarrying, but they must return the dowry. May God bless you in Jesus' name. The second one. Sir, is it proper for a wife dowry to be paid after the husband's death? The woman refused to do according to the traditional rite for the husband after his death. She was demanding for her dowry to be paid first before any traditional rite. Is there anything between the dead and the living? The man has failed to do the right thing when he was alive. Then why should the woman be forced to do any traditional rite for him after his death? Apart from that,
Why is this woman demanding for the dead to come and pay her dowry or traditional right or to pay anything on her?
Ki lo de ti obirin be ke en to ti ku ko wa san owo ori ohun tabi ko wa so nkohun
to se pelu asa won lati
pe ko si laye mo be ki gbogbo ake mo
that what we are talking about in this church is church marriage. The marriage that is laid on Christ the rock. Not the marriage that is laid on traditional rites. Let us open our Bible to the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 20. 1
Corinthians
chapter 10.
Orikewa.
You can read from 19 to 21, but I just read 20 for you.
Ele ka te ba dele ni ese kokorin ogun de kokorilogun subo ma ka ese ogun fun wa.
But I say that the things which the Gentiles sacrifice, they sacrifice to the devils and not to God, and I will not that ye should have fellowship with the devils.
Ṣùgbọ́n tí mo wí ni pé ohun tí àwọn kèfèrí fi rúbọ wọn fi rúbọ sí àwọn ẹ̀mí èṣù kì í sì ṣe sí Ọlọ́run èmi kì í sì èmi kò sì fẹ́ kí ẹ̀yin kí ó bá àwọn ẹ̀mí èṣù ṣe àjọpín.
So
nítorí náà
I'm asking the woman
wa n bèrè lọ́wọ́ arábìnrin náà
not to put herself
kó má ṣe fi ara rẹ̀
under any bondage
sínú ìgbèkùn yòówù
by receiving the dowry from the dead man.
Látàrí pé yóò tẹ̀síwájú láti lọ gba owó orí lọ́wọ́ ẹni tí ó ti di òkú.
The Lord will bless you.
Kí Ọlọ́run kí ó bùkún rẹ.
As God has losing you from evil bondage, you too, you should lose yourself from this bondage.
Jọ̀wọ́ gẹ́gẹ́ bí Ọlọ́run ti tú ọ sílẹ̀ kúrò ní ìgbèkùn wọn pàápàá já ara rẹ gbà kúrò nínú rẹ.
As I told you.
Gẹ́gẹ́ bí mo ti sọ fún ọ.
A man failed.
Ọkùnrin náà kùnà.
To pay your dowry before he died.
Kò san owó orí rẹ kí ó tó kú.
So you have no right.
O wà ní ẹ̀tọ́ kankan.
To go for any demonic traditional rites.
Láti ṣe àṣà wọn gẹ́gẹ́ bí wọ́n máa ń ṣe fún àwọn òkú.
The third question.
Ìbéèrè kẹta.
Dear pastor.
Olùṣọ́ àgùntàn wọn.
Dr. Dike Olukoya.
Ọmọwé Dike Olukoya.
The GO.
Alábòjútó àgbà.
I am ready to obey the Lord.
Mo ti ṣetán láti gbọ́ràn sí Olúwa.
I have been praying and fasting.
Mo ti ń gbà àdúrà, mo sì ti ń gbàwẹ̀.
For a future partner.
Láti mọ ẹni tí wọn ò fẹ́.
Yet.
Síbẹ̀.
I don't know who the Lord God want me to marry.
Mo mọ ẹni tí Olúwa Ọlọ́run fẹ́ kí n fẹ́.
Sir.
Alàgbà.
Please, how do I know my wife?
Báwo ni wọ́n ṣe mọ ìyàwó tó yẹ kí n fẹ́?
I need the will of God.
Mo fẹ́ kí ìfẹ́ ti Ọlọ́run.
To prevail.
Kó jọba.
As I'm planning to travel abroad.
Látàrí pé mo ń ṣètò láti rìnrìn àjò lọ sí òkè òkun.
To marry a white lady.
Láti lọ fẹ́ aláwọ̀ funfun.
What do I do?
Kí wá ni kí n ṣe báyìí?
Or how do I know the will of God?
Tàbí báwo ni ṣe mo fẹ́ mọ ìfẹ́ Ọlọ́run?
Praise the Lord.
Ẹ kí hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Ẹ kí hallelujah.
Amen.
Àmì.
If you are going to marry a white lady.
Tó yẹ pé aláwọ̀ funfun ló fẹ́ fẹ́.
You are going to marry by contract.
O fẹ́ fẹ́ ìgbéyàwó àdéhùn ni.
And that contract can be broken at any time.
Àdéhùn tẹ́yìn méjì jọ ní ìgbà yóò wulẹ̀ lè dá lẹ́yọ̀pẹ́ ẹ̀ ò ṣe mọ́.
You have said you have been praying.
O sọ pé o ti ń gbàdúrà.
You have been fasting.
O ń gbàwẹ̀ tí.
I will just advise you to continue to pray and wait on the Lord.
Má kàn gbà ọ́ níyànjú pé tẹ̀síwájú nínú àdúrà kó o sì máa dúró de Olúwa.
For his divine intervention.
Fún ìdásí rẹ̀ láti òkè wá.
Many of us can pray.
Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ wa ni a lè gbàdúrà.
We can fast.
A lè gbàwẹ̀.
But.
Ṣùgbọ́n.
We don't wait on the Lord.
A ò kí ń dúró de Olúwa.
My brother.
Arákùnrin mi.
There must be a way that God talks to you.
Tí Ọlọ́run fi ń bá ọ sọ̀rọ̀.
When you finish praying.
Nígbà tó bá gbàdúrà rẹ tán.
Wait and listen.
Farabalẹ̀ kí o tẹ́tí gbọ́.
To the answer from God.
Sí èsì tàbí ìdáhùn láti ọ̀dọ̀ Ọlọ́run.
White lady is not the best choice for you.
Aláwọ̀ funfun kò ń ṣe ohun tí ó dára jùlọ fún ọ o.
The Lord will bless you in Jesus' name.
Kí Ọlọ́run kí ó bùkún ọ nírúkọ Jésù.
Let's rise to our feet, please. Kájìdé dúró. Father, we thank you for this session before you. And we commit every family presented there unto your holy hands. Father, lay your hands upon them in the name of Jesus. Let every family presented there this morning experience the touch of Jehovah in the name of Jesus. The Lord God, who is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, will soak every family in the blood of Jesus. Every agenda of darkness for every home, let that agenda be scattered in the name of Jesus. Thank you. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Now say this again after me loud and clear. My Father, my Father. Defend your interest in my life. In the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and decree it. My father. Defend your interest in my life. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Say, oh God, arise.
Oh Lord, today
laminate my family with the fire of the Holy Ghost. In the name of Jesus, open your mouth and pray like that. Laminate my family with the fire of the Holy Ghost. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Let us share the grace and fellowship.
Jesus Christ. The love of God and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Seven Jericho destroying. Hallelujah.